Hi everyone, Nick here, and in our last video, we made this horizontal bar chart with a vertical trend line. We used the add trend line feature in PowerPoint and in the chart making software itself. But what if you had a chart like this, but instead of an annual average, you wanted to show a historic monthly average? So each of the months might have their own individual unique value for that trend line. We can't use the same process. So that will look something like this. And we can't use that same trend line process for individual values for the trend line on each individual bar. So we have to do a couple extra things and a little Excel or PowerPoint trickery in order to make that happen. So I found a video from Jeff Lennings at Excel University, and I'll link to him in the description below. I hope you go and check out his video and check out Excel University and the Excel courses that they have. I reached out to Jeff and I asked him if I could show everyone how I used his steps in making my own chart, and he said of course. So thank you very much, Jeff, for your approval, your permission, and for your support here. Now, what we're going to do is first, I've already set up my horizontal bar chart here, my clustered bar chart. This is just like the one we did before. One series, the blue series here is my actual satisfaction data, and the teal series is my historic monthly average data. So each individual month has its own individual value. Now, if we were to right click and add trend line like we did before, you're going to get a trend line that goes across all those bars. We don't want that, so we're going to delete it. I'm going to walk you through the steps that Jeff did in his video, and it's a really clever trick to create this sort of these sort of trend lines on individual bar effects. So let's go ahead and try something out here. So first, what we're going to do is I'm going to overlap the bars so that they're completely overlapped together. So over in the format data series, we're going to go and select 100%. So now they're all overlapped. Now the trend line or the individual threshold bars that we'll have are over here and they're underneath that bar. We actually need to put them on a secondary axis. So you're going to click those bars, that highlights all of the bars. And over here under Format Data Series, we will put this on a secondary axis. When you do that, you see that next axis pop up on the top. Really important that we make sure that both axes match. So this top one here is 0 to 100%, the bottom is 0 to 100%, that's perfect. A lot of times when you insert a series on a secondary axis, the secondary axis gets a little wild, so you have to update that axis once you do that. So, but this is good, we're perfect for now. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the paint bucket. We're going to fill the bars with no fill, just like we did in our last bucket, so we're going to make them invisible. And now what we're going to do is we're going to add a shadow effect to these bars. So keep this series highlighted. Go up here to the Format Data Series menu under the Effects tab right here. And under Shadow, we're going to just say the outer. And then you have a bunch, you can see now a little drop shadow has appeared on those bars. What we're going to do now is adjust some of the settings here. So under transparency, we're going to go down to 0. The size, we're going to keep 100%. The blur will go down to 0. The angle will go down to 0. And now you can see something happening, and the distance will keep at 3. So now when I unclick out of this, you can see that drop shadow no longer appears as a shadow. It's actually just on the outside of that bar, which is pretty cool. Now, since this is on the secondary axis, we can play with the gap width of each individual series of bars. And I really want this set of bars, my threshold line bars, to be a little wider than the other bars. So right now it's set to 182. I'm going to set this all the way down to 30. And you can see that gets bigger. When I click out, you can see that those threshold markers are bigger than the blue bars. You can also see maybe in PowerPoint, you can see very faint outlines of the bars. I have set this to no fill and no outline. So if you go into slideshow mode, you can kind of see what your audience or your presentation audience would see. And you can see that none of those little faint lines are around those bars. So that's just kind of something I think Microsoft is telling me. There is a series of bars here. Now for the blue bars, I'm going to go ahead and we'll update that to that gray color, solid fill and gray. And maybe I want these to be a little wider. Right now they're 182 for the gap width. Let's go down to 100. And that makes them a little bit bigger there. Very nice. Now, there's one thing that I remember from my first chart, and that was that I wanted my benchmark lines, my threshold lines, to be blue, that blue color. So let's actually go back and highlight, select those bars, and then go back to my shadow effects, and then under color, right here it's black, let's set that to blue. So that's how you can change the color here. But I also still wanted this to remain in my legend, and you can see right at the top, as soon as I made those bars no fill or invisible, the monthly average, that blue box that was, or the black box that was next to that monthly average, has now become invisible. So let's actually try and get this back. So what I have to do, and I should have done this from the beginning, let's highlight the threshold bars again, the marker bars. Let's make everything blue. Once I do that, you can see now at my in my legend here, the monthly average turns blue again. Now, what I need to do, if I highlight one bar and it highlights all of them, and I collect and I select no fill, the blue box goes away from the legend. I'm going to undo that. What I have to do is I have to isolate each individual bar and select no fill on individual bars if I want the legend to remain active. So let's go ahead and select this again. Now you can see just the top bar for January is selected. I'm going to click on no fill, and now you can see that blue box next to monthly average has still remained blue. So I'm going to go ahead and isolate each of these individual bars. Make sure to isolate every single one. We'll go down the list and select no fill on all of these. It is looking pretty good. And we'll see a couple more tweaks that we might want to provide. So one thing is we can get rid of the secondary axis. I'm going to actually just make it white, maybe reduce the font size just a little bit in case I ever need it back. If something goes wild with this kind of secondary axis chart, it's usually because of that secondary axis. So bring that back and then make sure that both axes are matching. If I wanted to do this, I could also recolor these individual bars, just like we did in that first video. All of those summer months, it looks like the summer months are doing really good this year compared to historic average. And you can see that satisfaction score is still gray, but since I'm using that color, I'm just going to go ahead and delete this part in my legend. And then now I can make this whole thing blue. And that looks really, really nice. Now there is a limitation to this method, and it's not technically precise in terms of that error, in terms of that threshold marker bar. It's just a tiny bit above the value that it says it is. So I'm going to show you what I mean by that. I'm going to have to zoom in. So let's one way that we can really easily see this is if I set one of those markers to one of the grid lines, because then so let's say 80%, let's say January, that marker should be at 80%. The blue line should completely overlap the gray grid line. So let's go ahead and select our data, right click, edit data, and let's update January's monthly average to 90%. Okay, I'm going to close out of my source data. Now you can see that threshold bar has updated to 90%, but you can see it's just on the other side of the grid line. So it's actually, 91% or maybe 90.5%. So if you're presenting this on the PowerPoint presentation to a large audience, I don't think anybody is really going to know. So this can be our little secret. But if you really wanted it to be a little bit more exact, we could probably play with the formula on the back end and maybe just reduce the value by just like a very minuscule amount. So let's actually go. What I'm going to do, and if this is going to mess up the chart a little bit, but I'm going to show you kind of the steps that I would use to do it. So let's calculate a new field for that. So what I'm going to do is right click, edit data. Our data source will pop up right here. I'm going to calculate a new field just kind of over here so that it doesn't mess with the dynamic table. But what I'm going to do is we'll say this is, I'll just say monthly average again. And I'm going to say equals, we're going to point to that benchmark, but then I'm going to subtract minus 0.0025. So it's not even 2.5% less, it's 0.25% less, and I'm going to click enter, and that's going to give me a value just slightly lower, and you might have to just play with this. I'm going to bring that formula down, so now this will be the new value that I associate with that benchmark in my actual chart. So what I'm going to do here is close out of that. I'm going to go up to the Chart Design tab and click on Select Data so that I can change where my data sources are pointed to. So here in the Select Data Source menu, we're going to go to Monthly Average, and when I click Edit, it will give me, I'll go ahead and click on the values here, and you can see in the spreadsheet, in the source sheet, it is pointing to the monthly average column, but now I'm going to change it to this new monthly average column that I just created. So let's go ahead and do that and push enter. I'm going to actually change where it's named as well. Just put it right there. Now when I push OK, we're going to look over at that 90% threshold marker to see if it's moved down just a little bit and completely overlaps that grid line. So let's push OK. Push OK again, and then we're going to get out, and now you can see it completely messed up my formatting, so I have to go back and redo the formatting on this series of bars. So let's go ahead and select No Fill, and then redo our shadow effect. Zero transparency, zero blur, zero angle, and there we go, and let's make it blue. Perfect. Now, if I scroll over just a little bit, I'm going to zoom way in. You can see that that marker now is pretty well overlapping that grid line. So that was probably a lot of work for something we didn't really need to do. The juice might have not have been worth the squeeze. But it is a little trick that you can keep up your sleeve in case you see something that might not be that accurate. So let's go back and look at our finished chart, our finished product. Oh, and you can see my monthly average, the threshold, that little blue box went away because I no-filled the entire series. I didn't go that trick one by one bar, by one bar, by one bar. But that's okay. Even if it's just this blue text, I think that does the trick. And you can really get a sense of this type of chart to see, like, you know, maybe the annual average wasn't doing it for us and we really wanted to have some more historical context around the satisfaction scores and the monthly, the each of the individual monthly scores. And so this is kind of a way that you could do that with that horizontal bar chart with the vertical threshold markers on the chart. So I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. I appreciate it if you hit that subscribe button. And if you'd like notifications every time I post a new video, you can just hit that bell and adjust the settings there to get the notifications up in your YouTube app. So thanks again for watching. I had a really great time. Hope you have a great day, and I will see you next time. Thank you.